Good morning. We have a panel discussion here. The topic is realization of Atmanirbhar Bharat. And we have panelist Sri Sudhanshu Mani. He is a retired GM ICF and independent consultant. And we have on board as Sri H.K. Raghu. He is a ED RDSO on urban transport. And we have Mr. V.R. Sharma. And so I request Mr. Mani sir, please give your views on the realization of Atmanirbhar Bharat.
Yeah. Good morning to all of you. I'll start with my simple discourse on Atmanirbhar. So what is Atmanirbhar? As envisaged, it is for importance of promoting local products, given a thumbs up by money as the need, by many as the need of the hour, to defend the country against the overwhelming impairment caused by COVID. Now, it is my discourse again here that for a country of our size, this is cynical to begin with. We had a program called Make in India already in hand, which was again about manufacturing in India and did not really lay any stress on design and innovation in the country, a product design, but merely part manufacturing in the country. And Atmanirbhar is the post-COVID avatar of Make in India. After Atmanirbhar was announced, so there were definitely policy provisions, regulatory policies and provisions, which concentrated on easy financing to animate our dormant entrepreneurial spirit and revamp the philosophy to build a new India with global manufacturing moving to India. So all this about financing, and also to some extent, although economists felt that enough was not done, also to boost demand, is something which is for economists to talk about. So I will not go into that area. I will start with what I understand should be the spirit of Atmanirbhar. There is a Atmanirbhar circular of government which defines local content, which is the amount of value added in India which shall, unless otherwise prescribed by the nodal ministry, be the total value of the item procured, excluding net domestic indirect taxes, minus the value of the imported content in the item, including all custom duty, as a proportion of total value. And this was prescribed as 50% for class A and 20% for class B and so on. But the dichotomy here is the open manipulation of importing, say, something at 1,000 rupees, selling it for 3,000 without adding any value. But going by this circular, you can easily claim that you were adding 50% value in the product. So these circulars and this bowdom of handling things will not work. The idea was that the Make in India lions should roar into becoming Atmanirbhar. But what has happened that it has just been purring a little bit. Okay. What is innovation? Why do I talk of innovation? First of all, for innovation to burgeon, a playing field skewed in favor of Indian products has to be there. Not a level playing field, or rather what we have today is a playing field skewed in favor of established companies, totally killing the spirit of innovation. Or leverage the volumes which a large country like ours should have with stringent terms favoring genuine know-why, know-how to be transferred, the volume offered, afford it so that in future it is through your own efforts and not by any transfer of Nova Innova. The cycle of innovation is complete when the underlying idea is successfully transformed into practical reality for an enterprise in a product, process, or business concept, or a combination that, when activated in real world, the marketplace gives you an outcome of value. That's the cycle of innovation, number one. And technology is systemic knowledge to and skill to manufacture, construct, put together a product or service, employing an input artistry and expertise with techniques, methods, and processes with the help of specifically allied equipment if required for a particular usage. That's technology. So then, can technology really be transferred? To my mind, technology, as I keep saying, transfer of technology is an oxymoron. Because I said that technology is basically creation of this. And that cannot be transferred through documents like drawings and specifications and protocols and so on. It is something that lives in the mind and heart of the creator. So there is something which would always be held back. And after a transfer of technology, as has happened in railways, you go rushing back to the market after 15 years to get a new set of technology instead of creating a technology yourself. I'm not against transfer of technology for areas such as, say, high speed. The best effort in the country, we may still not be able to design on our own. So you need a transfer of technology there. Only the caveat is that it should be so designed that we learn in the process. We'll come to that later if time permits. And we also need imports for certain things like machine tools, because they would be required for world-class manufacture, and our world machine tool industry is nowhere near giving us the machines that we can get from, say, Germany, or nowadays even countries like Taiwan and Korea. Now, so what has actually happened? I will give only 2-3 examples before I conclude. Take the e-bus sector. Are we not being told that by 2030, we'll have a very good penetration of e-vehicles in India? This is being talked about now for more than 5-6 years. So I'll take the example of e-buses. In India, we have 17 lakh buses plus. And the effort for e-buses started in 2016, I think, with FAME 1, and then later with the FAME 2 policy. In these 5-6 years of effort, can you imagine how many e-buses do we have in the country? Less than 2,000. And whatever we do have, has except the body, no technology. The heart is not our technology, is not even our product. The converters are imported, the battery, of course, because raw materials are available in China. Controls are imported. Everything is imported. For a country of our size, after 5 years of effort, we don't have our technology on the road. It is the government's job to encourage it, and how, I'll come to later. That's the status of e-buses. Similar is the status of solar panels. So we hear so much about it, and we have installed so many solar panels. But you would be aware that the heart, again, converter, the controls, and the cell itself are all imported. Recently, they have allowed assembly of cell, but the heart still would come from somewhere abroad. And then last, but not the least, our own metro sector. After more than 20 years of spending, nearly 7-8 lakh crores in the sector, with at least 2-2.5 lakh crores in the rolling stock and signaling, or maybe more. I don't have the latest figures. We don't have, after 21 years, a single Indian design of a metro coach. So what's so great about a metro coach? If you ask, compare metro coaches with Mumbai Suburban, they would think that metro coaches are much more stringent. No, sir. The level of service in, say, Mumbai Suburban, frequency is same, speeds are higher. And if a train fails, then you are looking at the people burning down the station. That's stringent service. It's just that the Mumbai Suburban trains don't look like a metro coach. The aesthetics are not there. They're not well done up. So it's only the interiors and the exteriors, not the heart. And still, it's because of these narrow-minded, blinkered policy of extra caution, overlooking the capability in the country, that we don't have a single metro design of our own. Imagine, the first metro in the country in 1980s was an Indian design with DC propulsion and so on. But this is the status today. All this has to be changed by providing a playing field which is skewed in favor of Indian companies. I'll conclude by saying that Atmanirbhar can become a reality only by effort of government, not so much by private company on their own, because government is a big spender and they have to take the lead. With this, their ordering skewed in favor of local development, not the other way around, will afford Indian companies a platform to first fail repeatedly, but then succeed with a product which will build, open up the future for them. And second is getting a technology wherever required in a manner where we leverage our volumes to learn and not be on the road to import again after 10 years. If these things are done, then true spirit of Atmanirbhar would be realized. Otherwise, it would remain what it so far has been, just a slogan. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your very good insight of understanding of Atmanirbhar Bharat. I just want to project some slides which are basically giving the status what actually been considered as Atmanirbhar Bharat by Government of India. So if you permit, I will share the slides.
Sure.
Sure, sir.
So basically, I will be just giving some slides over the Government of India policies for Make in India. And again, what is known now being called as Atmanirbhar Bharat, and the work done by the Metro Rail and the Ministry of Urban and Housing Affairs and Ministry of Railway at RDSO Lucknow. At RDSO Lucknow, Urban Transport and High Speed Directorate, RDSO Lucknow works as a single window service provider for technical clearance and safety certification of all the Metro Rail system over India. Till now, we have given about clearance for 14 metro systems, and these are starting from 2013 from Jaipur, then Chennai, Hyderabad, Gurgaon, Bangalore, and Mumbai. Then Kochi Metro, DMRC, Lucknow, Nagpur, Noida Metro, then Kolkata Metro, and then Nagpur Metro with a different rolling stock, and Gujarat Metro with a Hyundai Rotem rolling stock. The major observation what we have seen in RDSO by looking on all these metro systems, till now each metro system developed is different from the other. Rolling stock of one metro line cannot be utilized in any other metro. Technology of propulsion, DC traction and signaling and communication system are of PAC nature. Each metro project is therefore get loaded with undesired design and development cost for all these systems. Due to variation in design and size of component of one metro to other, the quantity requirement of one type of component is less than the break-even quantity for its indigenous production. As a result of this, local sources of subsystem and other things are not being developed. As regard Atmanirbhar Bharat, what Government of India says, Atmanirbhar Bharat is basically based on five pillars. Pillar number one is economy, and while we say about the economy, we are looking for a quantum jump and not the incremental changes. Regarding infrastructure, represents the modern India, and when we talk about the systems, technology driven systems has to be there. Regarding demography, vibrant demography, the largest democracy, and demand, full utilization of the power demand supply. Now in Atmanirbhar Bharat stimulus packages, five different packages are given. Package number one is for business, including the MSMEs. Package number two is poor, including the farmers. Package number three is agriculture. Package number four is new horizon for growth. And package number five is government reform and enabler. So steps to boost business in MSMEs. Emergency credit line to business MSMEs from banks and NBFCs up to 20% of entire outstanding credit as on 29/2/2020. Borrowers with up to rupees 25 crore outstanding and rupees 100 crore turnover are eligible. Loans to have 4-year tenure with moratorium of 12 months on principal repayment. Interest to be capped. 100% credit guarantee covers to bank and NBFCs on principal and interest. No guarantee fee, no fresh collateral. 45 lakhs unit can resume business activity and safeguard jobs. Rupees 20,000 crores has been given as subordinate debt for stressed MSMEs. Stressed MSMEs need equity support. Government of India will facilitate provision of rupees 20,000 crore as subordinate debts. 2 lakh MSMEs are likely to be benefited from it. Functioning MSMEs which are NPA or are stressed will be eligible. Government will be providing a support of rupees 4,000 crore to CGTMSE. CGTMSE will provide partial credit guarantee support to banks. Promoters of the MSME will give debt by bank, which will then be infused by promoters as equity in the units. Regarding subordinate debts, it may be a new concept for other people, but for bank people, it is very common. So the priority of payment, repayment is for subordinate debt is lesser than the senior debts. Means initially debts are being given, so the priority is number two and default is permitted. Rupees 50,000 crore equity infusion for MSMEs. MSMEs face severe shortage of equity. Fund of funds with corpus of rupees 10,000 crores is set up. Provide equity funds for MSMEs with growth potential and viability. FOF operation through a mother fund and few daughter funds. Funds structure leverage of rupees 50,000 crore for fund at daughter fund level. Expand MSME size as well as the capacity. Encourage MSMEs to get listed on main board of stock exchange. Now the government has also redefined the definition of MSMEs. Earlier, they were divided in three parts, micro, small, and medium. And in regard to manufacturing investment, if the manufacturing investment is less than 25 lakh, it is micro. If it is less than 5 crores, it is small. And if it is less than 10 crores, it's medium. Now the revised criteria says, if the manufacturing service investment is less than 1 crore, it is treated as micro. And small is lesser than 10 crores. And medium is lesser than 20 crores. In manufacturing services turnover, if we talk about the turnover, that has also been increased remarkably from 10 lakh to 5 crore for micro, and from 2 crore to 50 crore for small, and from 5 crore to 100 crore for medium interest. One more thing has been decided by Government of India that up to 200 crores worth of tender, no tender will be floated as a global tender unless the permission of Government of India is granted for that. So that is a basic booster for, this is an important government step towards Atmanirbhar to support Make in India environment. This is expected to help MSME to boost their business multifold. Other measures which are taken on the request of Government of India, RBI raised the ways and means advance limit of states by 60% and enhanced the overdraft duration limits. Issued all the pending income tax refund up to rupees 5 lakh immediately, benefiting around 14 lakh taxpayers. Implemented a special refund and drawback disposal drive for all pending refund and drawback claims. Both the above measures amount to rupees 18,000 crores for refund, sanction of rupees 15,000 crore for emergency health response packages. Provided relaxation in statutory and compliance matters, extending last date for income tax return, which is further been extended from June 30th to November 2020, extending filling GST return to the end of June 2020, 24/7 custom clearance till 30th June 2020, relaxation of 3 months for debit card holders to withdraw cash free from any ATM, allowing payment before 15th May 2020 for motor vehicle and health insurance policies, mandatory board meeting extended by 60 days till 30 September, allowing extraordinary journal meeting through video conferencing with e-voting, simplifying voting facilities. What measures have been taken by Reserve Bank of India? Reduction of cash ratio, cash reserve ratio has resulted in liquidity enhancement of rupees 1,37,000 crores, targeted long-term repo operations of rupees 1,50,000 crores for fresh deployment in investment grade. Similarly, increase in bank limit for borrowing overnight under the marginal standing facilities to the tune of 1,37,000 crores. Announced special finance facilities to NABARD, SIDBI and the NHB for total amount of rupees 50,000 crores at the policy repo rate. Announced the opening of a special liquidity facility for rupees 50,000 crore of mutual fund to alleviate intensified liquidity pressures. Easing of working capital finance by reducing margin. Relief to the contractors. Extension of up to 6 months without cost of contractor to be provided by all central agencies like Railways, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, Central Public Works Department, etc. Covers construction works and goods and services contracts, covers obligations like completion of work, intermediate milestone, etc. and extend of concession period in PPP contract. Extension of registration and completion date for real estate project under RERA, adverse impact due to COVID and project stand the risk of defaulting on RERA timeline need to be extended. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs will advise state obligatories and their regulatory authorities for the following effect. Treat COVID-19 as event of force majeure under RERA. So these are the new things which have come up. And now rupees 30,000 crore special liquidity scheme for financial institutions like NBFC, HFC and MIFC. Similarly, rupees 90,000 crore liquidity injection to DISCOMs, power distribution companies and power generation companies both have been given this advantage. And rupees 45,000 crore partial credit guarantee scheme is there. So now again the tax related measures which have been announced by government, and these are the other tax measures. So if we see this thing, and then again if we come to what opportunities, what has been done by say Indian Railway and Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog has announced Industry 4.0 incentives to launch a major incentive to push industries to adopt Industry 4.0. Industry 4.0 is characterized by increasing digitization and interconnection of product value chain and business model. Because unless our industries are Industry 4.0 compliant, they will not be able to export their item and sustain with the changes being done on day-to-day basis. Similarly, the development of industry that produce the key building blocks forming the basis of Industry 4.0 could be incentivized. So these are the some incentive has been given by Niti Aayog. Now, opportunity for Indian industries in National High Speed Rail Corporation Limited is Make in India effort, identifying items to make in India. As far as track items are there, there are about 12 items out of 20 items have been identified indigenization. Civil engineering, about 50 out of 52 items have been indigenized. Electrical and SMT, about 48 out of 78 items have been indigenized. And in rolling stock, about 6 items have been identified for the indigenization. Now the work which has already been done by MOUHA and Ministry of Railway, the standard of rolling stock and signaling system of metro rail in India have been notified in 2017 after the approval of Railway Board. The standards of rolling stock fixes the standard of civil structure. The standard of electrical system have been concurred by Railway Board and going to be notified soon. Various metro rails have already started procuring as per the notified standard. CBT system is also developed by BEL, CDAC, DMRC through MOUH. Now the issue which further need to be addressed is, as per my opinion, unless we go for a unified tender for rolling stock for either for full Indian metros or for the state owned metros, so that the number is sufficient in which the Indian company can come up for supplying it. So these are the manufacturing of propulsion system in India by PUs and private players like BHEL, BL, L&T, Kirloskar Electric Component Group, etc. can be taken up. Manufacturing of signal system in India by BL, CDEC and BL, TCS, etc. can be considered. Then immediate future need is to propagate the concept of one nation, one metro. Nowadays you are listening that everything is one nation, one ration card, one identity card, something like that. In the same way, to propagate the concept of one nation and one metro. This is the time to consolidate of Indian industries to manufacture of metro rolling stock in India. Titagarh Fema has won the international bid for manufacturing and supply of 102 ultra modern rolling stock to Pune Metro. Ministry of Railway and MOUHA are there to facilitate the investments by standardization. Niti Aayog has already published its policy to help Indian industries. Industry need to gear up to itself for Industry 4.0 standards. Now, if you see the GDP, the trend of GDP which you see, which has been projected by various agencies, in 2020, the GDP shown by RBI is -7.5%. But as per the expectations in 2021, it is to be boosted up to 11.5%. And these are the, again, the boost for MSMEs, which have already been explained to in earlier slides, and support mass manufacturing in India. Now I'll say, chalo, aao chale, Atmanirbhar Bharat ki or, dhanyavad and jai hind. Thank you very much. This is what I wanted to present, and now it is open for discussion.
Okay, sir. Very, very informative and knowledgeful session from Mr. Raghu, sir. Sir, here is a question from Mr. Asis Apte. He is telling, the ecosystem for the rolling stock and other developed much earlier in the most of the EU nation and China. So if we emphasize more on the ecosystem, we can also do this. I would like to thank you, Sri H.K. Raghu sir and Sri Zansumani sir. You guys, both of you giving me encouragement to do this kind of event. And I hope your support will be continuous.
Before I think you conclude, let me say my thanks to our senior Mr. Sudhansumani sir, who has shown the way to not only Indian Railway but to whole of India how we can really make in India, starting from the concept of 10-18 up to the final running of it. He was totally involved in it, and he has just reared it just like a child. So if somebody says ki ecosystem is not there, ecosystem is available in India. Only thing, you have to change your rules and regulations by which the Indian companies can come up and join the hand with the Indian Railways and government. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your enlightenment. And we keep on meeting in such meetings and keep on taking guidance from you, sir. Thank you, sir.
We tried very hard to do this in this situation. Yeah, please, sir.
Just 1 minute. So thank you, Raghu, for kind words. There's a lot of information in your presentation, especially for covering all the sectors. And I said government has done definitely a lot towards financing, to some extent towards generation of demand only. So I said some economists should be speaking about that, but you have done that job well. My idea once again, is very simple. It is the spirit. Unless you encourage innovation in the country, unless you encourage Indian companies with Indian designs, investing in future, allow them to fail and let them succeed on the stepping stone of failure, you will remain a net importer, which for a country of our size, in spite of such all these hullabaloo about Make in India and Atmanirbhar, is so unfortunate. Before leaving, I'll just leave a question for you. For example, this Make in India and Atmanirbhar is going on, but if you start looking in railway sector itself, you will not find one example of genuine Make in India, except barring some small components here and there. That's why a thorough review is required, and proof of the pudding is in the eating. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone.